Are you here?
I'm over here giggling. People are probably wondering what I'm laughing at. It's these guys.
There's rudeness here. See, Julie and I are trying to talk, and Daryl Holliday was coming to care of is being rude.
I'm just trying to figure out what's special about the black keys. The white keys are there, too.
I think it's just, you know, everyone has their time to shine.
Okay. Dan French is here. We got not one, but two Mr. Cleans with us today.
I know. I said they sat down, and I said, you guys are showing an awful lot of skin today.
That's what we do. That's what we do.
How was that, Daryl?
That was good. That wasn't bad.
Does that reserve me a spot on the stage?
I'll get you a spot on the stage. Absolutely.
Okay, Dan, you're at Comedy Caravan this week, so tell us what kind of show can folks expect when they come out?
Comedy. We go with comedy every night.
Funny.
Pretty straight.
Funny.
Pretty funny
comedy.
Guys.
Yeah. It's a very bald show. You may know.
Y'all got the black memo. We got the bald memo.
I know, right? So now, is that something when you're on stage? Because Daryl comes on and he always is talking about his dome.
No,
so
you're the one always. Talking
I don't
about
do that. That's
dome.
You.
Yeah, she
you
did.
Bring it up. So I'm just wondering, is that something? Did you make that part of your routine,
or
do
you kinda, let other? You kind of have to address it at some point.
Yeah.
People kind of notice.
Well,
but like being bald's kind of going around. I don't know if you've noticed. It's like I was at a four-way intersection a while back. Four cars, four bald guys.
No way.
Yeah, and one
and
of
you guys
cars,
do that beep at each other like motorcycle drivers
do? We just look at each other
do.
Like, what's up?
Yeah, it's kind of like a brotherhood, right?
Yeah, and one of the guys had a baby in his car, also bald.
Now see, but everybody can't pull off the bald look. You have to, you know, have a special, I don't know, special shaped head or something, but everybody can't do it. But you all are pulling it off quite well.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're very
welcome.
That's the weakest compliment you could give. You look okay, bald.
Michael Jordan,
quite disgusting.
Exactly.
Michael Jordan, Daryl Holliday. Hey, let's tell you a little bit about the Comedy Caravan. There's so much going on there throughout the week. You can get down there and see a magic act.
A lot of things.
You can see some jazz. And the thing I like about it, Daryl, is you can have a fundraiser, you can have a party in the air conditioning, and now's the time to start thinking about fall banquets and fall events going on, because you're taking those schedulings right now.
That's right. We're already taking Christmas parties and stuff, too. So it fills up fast. So you add the Italian buffet that we just added on Friday and Saturday
that's
night.
Awesome.
It's a great place to do fundraising, group events, birthday parties, bachelorette parties. We have a lot of those. So we just, you know, it's a good
divorce
place to go.
Divorce parties.
We've had a couple of those.
Right,
and the food is coming from
Ramsay's
across the street.
Yeah, we got to tell you, we saved one dairy clean blizzard here.
It's an Oreo.
I must admit, we were going to give it to Nick Hoff, our comedian at the Wall today, but you know what happened?
She actually licked off of this.
Put it down.
That's Becca's.
Nick, though, our comedian over on the Wall, he's probably really looking forward to
that. You wanted that blizzard, didn't you?
I do want it.
But you can't, because it's Becca ate. It's hers now.
Okay, that's all right.
Well,
they're serving all day,
apparently.
We'll see what we can do. It's 10 a.m. Why wouldn't I be mainlining ice cream? Seems like the right thing to do. I do like Dairy Queen, though. It seems like they're not trying to be something that are not, like McDonald's or something, who's serving salads now. And they actually have a chart up on the Wall at McDonald's. I don't know if you guys have seen this one that like tells you the fat content and the Big Mac, like anybody's really checking that and changing their mind. Like, oh, son of a gun, the Big Mac isn't good for you. Huh. You know, I think that chart up at McDonald's should just read, sorry, our bad. It's terrible for you, but it's ready right now. Yeah, I tell you what. I'll tell you who's not trying to be healthy is Taco Bell. They're, you know, not fat enough. How about a fourth meal? Come on and get this. Here's our spokesman, Charles Barkley. He's just professionally fat. That's what he does. And thank you for that rim shot. I don't know. I just recently saw that Taco Bell's actually serving Doritos now with their meals. I don't know what they have to do with Doritos. Hey, we found these at 7-Eleven. Do you guys want them? I don't know what the deal. If you order a meal at Taco Bell now, it comes with a Pepsi, a questionable taco, and Doritos. Two of the three things they did not make. I'm just going to open up my own restaurant, serve microwavable popcorn and Snickers. Hey, you guys, we just whipped this up and back. Welcome to Nick's. For those of you whose remote is not broken at home, maybe you've watched Shark Week a little bit, and I love the Shark Week. I'm terrified of them, though. I live out in Los Angeles right now, and I do not go in the ocean. I am terrified to death. But when I first moved out there, all the friends I met were surfers. They're like, Nick, don't worry about sharks, brother, because scientists say sharks don't even like the taste of us. So what? I don't like the taste of ramen noodles. I eat it out of survival. These are animals. I don't know if you caught that. And they don't like the taste of me? Isn't that too late? I'm already bit in half. I really give a squat if you didn't enjoy the flavor. No, thank you guys very much. My name's been Nick Hoff. I'm at the Comedy Caravan. Come
Nick
see
Hoff.
Let's see. See, I think that warrants a blizzard.
Did I get the ice cream?
Come on over, Blizzard.
I think you get the ice cream.
Come on over, Blizzard.
Yes, we need to share.
Maybe he could get Becca to feed him.
I don't know if we have another spoon.
That's possible. Well, guys, he's headlining this.
But you don't have a mic on, so you have to hug.
You have
to whisper into Dan's neck here like this.
Guys, get out to Comedy Caravan this week. You'll see Dan French with Nick Hoff and Donna Watts tonight through Sunday. Tickets are $8.
That's our MC.
Donna Watts is the MC, Craig.
Very funny.
459-0022 is the number to call. And
Craig, if you come out once in a while, you would know who some of these comics are, but you never come out to Comedy.
I've made my visit, right?
All I know is Dan French, Nick Hoff. They rock. They're the best. That's all I need to know this
great
week.
Great comedy club. Come out. Absolutely. Nick's going to be eating blizzards tonight.
And do you know where Nebraska is?
Where Nebraska is? I'm just going to take a step. Nebraska it would be north of.
It's in that middle part.
Does it touch Montana?
We don't have electricity yet. So.
Not yet, but maybe after the slide.
Really? It doesn't? I don't ever even look at that part of the map. I don't know.
Did you graduate high school? Ow.
Check your resume.
I'm just saying.
Hit him with a blizzard.
I would challenge. I don't know how many people know where Nebraska is out there right off the top of their head.
Can you travel around the country, different comedy caravans, and you got the mic on, and if Nick wants to weigh in, he's got to hug you. But what you go around to other different comedy cans. I know folks in Louisville love their comedy. How are things here when you come in?
Oh, great. I mean, this is one of the best comedy clubs in the country.
Yes. Been,
sure. I started here 22 years ago.
Wow.
I was from Louisville. I went to DeSales High School, Catholic boy. I started here 22 years ago, went on to write for David Letterman and a bunch of other shows because of this club. It's just a great training ground. It really is one of the best clubs around.
Yeah, you all draw talent. I mean, we have so much talent right here in Louisville, but you all draw talent nationally as well. So that's just a testament. Everybody knows about Comedy Caravan.
It is great having a company that's not only an icon in Louisville, but we have comedians moving to Louisville just because of the comedy community. Leave that blizzard.
So Nick, are you thinking about moving to Louisville?
She wants the blizzard.
What do you think so far?
Definitely.
He lives in LA now.
Let's give you some free tickets to Comedy Caravan. All you got to do is email Daryl at ComedyCaravan.com, and say, okay, we have our DeSales High School graduate here. You could talk about either one of them. Nick, you can also talk about Dan. Why do you want to go to the Comedy Caravan? Email right now.
And
name,
Nick just
address,
because we're funny.
And by the way, Nick, I was not knocking or making fun of Nebraska by any means. I just don't know.
Where are you from?
Do you? You don't know where it is.
They're in the Big Ten right now.
Do you?
Where are you from?
I'm from Kentucky.
Yeah, the Big Ten.
You know where that's
six
at?
Now?
Do you know where Nebraska is?
Yes, I do.
It's right next to
this morning.